Devahuti said, I am very sick of the disturbance of my material senses. For because of this sense disturbance, my Lord, I have fallen into the abyss of ignorance.
Nidbinya Nitarang Bhuman Asat India Tarsana Yena Sambhab Manena Prapannandam Samap Prabho. So this material world is described in the Vedic literature as darkness. Actually it is darkness, therefore we require the sunlight, the moonlight, the electric light. If it had not been darkness, then why so many light arrangement? Actually it is darkness. Artificially, we made it light. Therefore, Vedic injunction is that don't keep yourself in the darkness. Tamasi ma. Jyotirgama. Go to the light. That light is the spiritual world. That is, directly the effulgence or bodily rays of Krishna. Jasya prabha prabhavato jagadanna koti koti su asesa vasudhadi vibhuti hinnam tad brahma niskalam anantam asesa bhutam govindam adi purusam tamaham bhajami. So, real business of especially of human being, the animals, they do not know, they have no capacity to know that we are in the darkness. Darkness of knowledge and actually darkness. So one has to become nirbhinya, disgusted. One intelligent man should be disgusted. One must be intelligent to know that I am eternal, na hannate hannamane sarire. It is the preliminary study of Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is instructing about the constitutional position of the soul. Na hannate hannamane sarire. Na jayate, na mriyate, kadachit, kadachit. At any time, the soul does not take birth, does not die. And more explicitly it is said, na hannate hannamane sarire. The covering, the body is the covering. So after destruction of this body, the soul is not destroyed. Just like if I change my shirt and coat, or somehow or other the shirt and coat is destroyed, I, the person who puts on this dress, am not destroyed. this simple knowledge is instructed in the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita. There are so many big scholars, big leaders, and still they cannot understand that I am not this body. This is the result because they do not study Bhagavad Gita in the proper way. We have got so many leaders, big leaders. They are teaching Bhagavad Gita. But nobody is fully aware or convinced that I am not this body. This is called darkness. And when one becomes disgusted with this darkness or this position in the darkness, that is human life. Tasmad gurum prabhadeta jignyasu sreya uttamam. Such person who has become disgusted with this material existence, he requires the instruction of a guru. So here, Devahuti, because she is the wife of a great yogi, she understands what is the constitutional position of herself, and he has got her son, the incarnation of God. So she is putting her problem to the teacher. It doesn't matter because Kapildev is the son of Devahuti. Devahuti does not deny to take instruction from him. She does not say, "Oh, he is my son. What he can instruct me? I am his mother. I shall instruct." No. Instruction has to be taken from the person who is in knowledge. It doesn't matter what is his position. It doesn't matter whether he is son or a boy or a Shudra or a Brahmana or a Sannyasi or a Grihastha. It doesn't matter. You should take instruction from a person who knows, who is in the knowledge. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. He said, when he was talking with Ramananda Rai, Ramananda Rai was a Shudra by caste. We have got the fourth division, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra. So he was, Ramananda Rai was by caste a Shudra. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a high-class Brahmin. Not only Brahmin, he was a sannyasi, the most exalted post. First of all, he is Brahmin. Of course, unless one is Brahmin, he cannot take sannyas. That's a fact. So he was, from social point of view, he was son of Jagannath Misra, grandson of Nilamba Chakravarti. Personally, he was learned scholar, born in a very high-class Brahmin, very beautiful body, young man, all qualified. And he was taking instruction from Ramananda Rai, who was a Shudra. The Chaitanya Charitamrita you will find. So Ramananda Rai, he was not only Shudra, he was Grihastha. And he was a politician, governor of Madras. But he was very exalted in spiritual knowledge. So after converting Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decided to go to the southern part of India, South India, at that time, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he was a very learned scholar, logician, nayayik. So he wanted to teach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu because he was a young man. But later on, he accepted Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his guru. He was impersonalist, Mayavadi, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained to him the Vedanta Sutra. The Vedanta Sutra is personal philosophy, so he was convinced and he became his disciple. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going to South India for his touring, he specially requested him that I neglected this person, Ramananda Rai. He was talking with me about spiritual subject matter, very highly elevated, that I thought that he was a sentimentalist, so I neglected him. But I can understand now that he is very exalted personality. When you are going to South India, please meet him. Please try to meet him. He will be very much pleased. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Kabul, he met Ramananda Rai and he was talking about spiritual subject matter, very highly elevated, simply. So because he was born in a Shudra family and a Grihastha and a politician, so he was hesitating. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Brahmin and Sannyasi, such exalted, hesitating. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that kiva vipra kiva shudra nasi kane noy jei krishna tattva vetta sei guru. Don't hesitate. Why you are hesitating? Because you are grihastha or you are in politics or you are born of a shudra family. Why you are? I am learning from you. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's preaching. He did not think anyone negligible. Anyone who is qualified with Krishna consciousness, he can become guru. It doesn't matter where he is born, what is his family and identification, it doesn't matter. He must know the science. It is very practical. Just like when you go to consult an engineer or a medical man or some lawyer, you do not ask him whether he is a Brahmin or Shudra. If he is qualified, if he can help you in the particular subject matter, you consult with him, you take his help. That is practical. So similarly, in the spiritual matter, it doesn't matter what he is. If he knows Krishna, then he can become guru. It doesn't matter. So here also, Devahuti, she was taking lesson from her son because the son knew the science of Krishna. It doesn't matter whether one is son or one is something else, or born in Shudra family or Brahmin family or a sannyasi. We are concerned with the science of Krishna. That is required. Chanakya Pandit also, he was a politician, you know Chanakya Pandit. Under his name, there is New Delhi, a quarter, Chanakya Puri. He was a great politician, Prime Minister of Samrat, Emperor Chandragupta. He also advises, he has got a moral instruction, Chanakya Slok. He says that Vishadapi Amritam Grahyam. In the poison pot, if there is nectarine, you should accept it. Don't neglect it because it is on the poison pot. You are concerned with the nectarine. Take it. Vishadapi amritam grahyam amedhyat api kanchanam. In a filthy place, suppose in your laboratory, in a very filthy place, there is gold. So it doesn't matter. You should take it, gold. It is not that the gold is in the filthy place, therefore you should not touch it. The other metal you should cannot touch. That is bathing engines. But gold you can take. Amedhyat api kanchanam. Vishadapi amritam grahyam amedhyat api kanchanam. Nichadapi. Duskuladapi. You can take some teachings even one is born in lower grade family. and the wife you can accept even if she is qualified and Sri Ratnam Duskula Adapi. Sri Ratnam. Ratna means jewel. If one girl is very qualified or beautiful, even she is born of lower family, you must accept. You can marry. This is Chanakya Pandit. Sri Ratnam Duskula Adapi. Vishadapam Matam Grayam Amidhyadapi Kans Nichadapi. Vidya. If a man born in niche, in lower grade family, but if he is qualified, it doesn't matter. That is practically being done. So, this is Vedic system. Not that one is lower in the estimation of the society by birth or some, but he must be qualified. So here also, it doesn't matter. This is why under this Vedic system. Devahite does not deny to take instruction from her son. It is the system. It doesn't matter whether it is inferior. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sai Guru. You will accept anyone as Guru if he knows the science of Krishna. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructed everyone to become a guru. The world is suffering for want of Krishna consciousness. That was his mission. He wanted that from India, everyone should become a guru and preach outside. Because there is no Krishna consciousness. That is Chaitanya. Amar agnay guru hoya. Taros hadbodesh or taro eidesh. You become a guru on my order and you deliver your country or other countries. So I have no qualification, I have no education. How can I become guru? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Amar Agnay, by my order. Then what is your order, sir? Now my order is, Jare Dakho Tare Kaho Krishna Upadesh. This is my order. You simply explain what Krishna has said or what has been said about Krishna. That is Krishna Upadesh. Krishna Upadesh means what Krishna is instructing, the Bhagavad Gita, the Supreme Personality, Krishna, he is instructing. That is Krishna Upadesh. And Srimad Bhagavatam is speaking about Krishna. That is also Krishna. Krishnasya Upadesha iti Krishna Upadesh. And Krishna, and subject matter Krishna and Upadesh, that is also Krishna Upadesh. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that you simply preach Krishna Upadesh. Then you become Guru. Amar Agnay Guru Haiya Taro Yai Desh Jare Dakho Tare Kaho Krishna Upadesh. Not only that, he has empowered all Indians. Bharat Bhumite Manusha Janma Hoilo Ja. Janma Sarthak Kari Karo Paropaka. This Krishna Consciousness Movement, to spread this Krishna Consciousness Movement, is the best welfare activity in the human society. The best. There is no more better welfare. There are so many welfare activities in the human society. But this Krishna Upadesh to instruct people about the primary principles of Bhagavad Gita in the human society, that is the best paropokara. People do not know how to become happy. They are manasasthani indriyani prakritisthani karsat. They are simply making struggle for existence by mental concoction. Manasasthani indriya. Prakriti sthani karusati. In this material world, they are simply struggling. There is no solution. Therefore, every Indian should study Bhagavad Gita and if possible Srimad Bhagavatam and assimilate it and preach all over the world. This is the duty of India. India has no other duty. Paropokar. So, with our one man's endeavor, teeny effort, we can see that so many outsiders that are attracted to Krishna consciousness. Unless there is something substance, they are not illiterate, they are not fools, they are not poor. Why they are attracted? There is something to be learned from Krishna consciousness. So if this Krishna consciousness movement is spread all over the world regularly, then the face of the world will change. That's a fact. Sarve sukhina bhavantu. This is the Vedic mission. Let everyone become happy. And how he will be happy? He cannot become happy by mental concoction. That is not possible. Manorathena asato dhavato bahi. If one is situated on the mental platform speculating, he will simply go to the asat. Asat means this material world. Asato ma, sadgama. Vedic says, don't remain in this asat. Come to the sat. Om Tat Sat. So, if one is on the mental speculation, manufacturing something for the welfare of the human society, that is not possible. Human society cannot be happy without Krishna consciousness. That's a fact. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktanam Jagatavusam Sarvalokumahesaram Sridam Sarvabhutanam Yatya Mam Shanti Michyati. If you want shanti individually or collectively, nationally or internationally, then you must become Krishna consciousness. What is that Krishna consciousness? Summary is that Krishna is the supreme enjoyer. Bhokta. We are not bhokta. We are simply servant. Just like anywhere, there is master and the servant. The master is the enjoyer and the servant is helping the master enjoy. This is the process. So we living entities, we are eternal servant of God or Krishna. When you speak of Krishna, means God. So we are eternal servant of God. So our duty is to help the master to enjoy. Just like here is Krishna, the Srimati Radharani, she is the topmost servitor of Krishna. So her business is to keep pleased always Krishna. That is the symbolic representation. Radha means anaya aradhate. She is serving. The best service, anaya aradhate. Therefore, Krishna is very much fond of Radha, because she gives the best service to Krishna in so many ways. She has got 64 qualifications, that is mentioned. Therefore, she is so, pleasing to Krishna. Anaya aradhate iti radha. So our business is also like that. We are eternal servant of Krishna and we should render service to the best of capacity. That is our real constitutional position. But here Devahuti says that bhumam asad indriya tarsana, asad indriya tarsana. At the present moment, in this material world, we are busy to enjoy this material senses. This is our position. Everyone is satisfied. Indriyani pararahu, indriyabha param mana, manasastu paro buddhi. In this way you go. And when you go beyond the range of buddhi, that is soul, that is spiritual platform. And ordinarily, we are in the material platform, we are interested in gratifying senses. I like it, I must have it. But that sense gratification means we are becoming implicated. Implicated in the laws of nature. That is also stated in the Shastra. Nunam pramatta kuruti vikarma jat indriya pritaye aprinoti nasadh manne jato atmanayam asannapi klesadeyasa deha. This is the instruction in the Vedic literature that the people in this material world, they are very, very busy. Not only men, even the animals, even the birds, beasts, insects, you see, on the beach, there are so many dogs, they are assembled there for sex. So this is the material world, Indriya Priti. Therefore, Shastra says that human life should be conscious. They should think whether we shall spoil our lives simply by sense gratification or there is some other business. Yes, there is some other business. That is tapasya. That is tapasya means we should restrict sense gratification. Sense gratification, either regulated or non-regulated, is meant for animal life. Sense control is the human life. Therefore, you will find in Vedic culture, big learned scholars, big kings, they dedicated their life for tapasya. Tapo dibbang putrakajina suddheta satta. If you want to purify your existence, then you must take to the process of tapasya. Tapo dibbam. And what is that tapasya? Tapasya for realization of God. And then we shall be purified. What is the meaning of purify? Purification. Purification means we are eternal. And if we become purified from this material contamination, then we get back our eternal life, back to home, back to God. That is Nikar. That is for that, we have to accept little tapasya. Not to become sense gratifier like the dogs and hogs. That is not civilization. Nayang deha deho bhajang niloke kastan kaman arhati vir bhujang ji. This human life should be regulated in such a way that he hasn't got to satisfy the senses after taking so much hard labor. The modern civilization is like that. Everyone is engaged in hard labor, simply for satisfaction of the senses. So they have become mad, nunang pramat, kurute, and they are acting without any consideration of the effect. They do not consider whether it is sinful or not. They do not believe in the next life. They do not discriminate what is sinful, what is pious, nothing, exactly. Like animals. So Shastra says, this is not good. Here also, Devahuti says that bhuman asat indriya tarsana. Asat indriya tarsana. Actually, these senses are not real senses. It is covered, just like my this body, covered with this shirt or this cloth. It is not my real body. Although you see, this heart has got a hand. That hand is not a real hand. The real hand is within this heart. Similarly, our real body is within this body. Dehinasmin jatha dehe. Dehe. Dehina. Dehina means the real body or the spiritual body of the soul is within this body. Dehinasmin jatha dehe. And the body is changing. Kaumarajo vanang jara. It is sometimes child, sometimes youth, sometimes young man, sometimes old man, and then vanishes. There are six changes. So this is not a real body. But, and we are engaged in this unreal body sense gratification. We have got senses. So therefore Bhagavad Gita says, Sukham atantikam jatat otindriya grayam. Otindriya grayam. Beyond these senses. Therefore, these senses are to be purified. That is called tapasya. Tapodibbam. Sarvapadhi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. When we purify our senses, senses you cannot destroy, that is not possible. Just like somebody says that you become desireless. Desire is the mental activities. So we cannot be desireless, that is not possible. We have to purify the desire. That is the path. That is a commandment. Sarvapadhi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. Rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti rucha. Bhakti means that. Bhakti means that you are not required to destroy your senses, but you have to purify your senses. And when you purify your senses, then you can serve Krishna. Sarvapadhi nirmalam senses, Rishikena, by the senses, Rishikesa Sivanam, Sar Rishikesa, the master of the senses, Krishna's senses. We are just like part and parcel of Krishna. Just like this hand or this finger, at part and parcel of my body. Similarly, we are also senses, part and parcel of the spiritual body of Krishna. So, when we purify ourselves, then we act in our original constitutional position. Just as the finger is meant for serving my body, similarly, as soon as we are in the position of our original constitution, then we serve Krishna. Devahuti says that bhuman asad indiya tarsana, I am in this material world. In simple word, there is a Bengali part. Krishna bhuliya jeevi bhoga vancha kare, pasete mayatare japotiya dhare. We are purely part and parcel of Krishna. We are actually the senses of Krishna. And when we forget this position, and we want to satisfy ourselves, that is our material condition. Krishna bhuliya jeeva bhogavancha kare, pasate maya tare japutiya dhare. Then that is maya. When you are in ignorance that we are the part and parcel of the Supreme Being, and our duty is to satisfy Him, rishikina rishikesa sevanam, this is called bhakti. When we forget it, then we are fallen in this material world and we are busy in our personal sense gratification and implication. Implication means so long we'll continue to have this desire to satisfy our senses, we have to accept another body according to our desire. Krishna is so kind. If we want to become a tiger, Krishna will give you next life a tiger's body. And if you want to be a devotee, He will give you the same body. If you want to eat stool, then He will give you the body of a pig. And if you want to, that requires our own qualification. Karmanada yonetrena, janti deva pratadi iman pitrin janti pitrin. It is a preparation for the next life, as you want to enjoy your senses. So, why not prepare yourself to go back to home, back to Godhead, and prepare your senses like that? That is Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much.